Joseph, very pleased to be here. And so I will talk about Luca Loma, I'll give an introduction to Luca Loma Transformers. So, first will be an overview of the series of lectures. So, start as an initial take local non-Archimedean term F. So I will try to keep the same notation. So OF over the integers, PF over maximum algol, and F over the residual term. And P will be the characteristic of the residual term. So G will be the F point, F rational point of the connective collective group. So we will call it Blackboard G, defined about F. So examples that are we will see along the course will be first post G and F. Okay, today I will assume that G is H. G and F, and later we'll look at inner form of G, that's not today. Group which are a group which is closely connected to G and N, but which is that's different, like the SLF, which are in the matrix in G and N, which have determinant 1. Of the inner form of SLN, and also classical groups. So what I mean by classical groups are the following groups. So SP2F or SUN, which means SP2N is the group of isometry of an alternate non-degenerate linear form. So G, we'll call it a periodic group. title in the, of the event, representation of PLD group. But in fact, to study Langlands correspondence for G, one has to look at complex reductive group. Also, of course, the reductive group are, of course, important, but also the complex reductive group that I will call G check. So G, if G is fit, G check is not any, is not arbitrary. G check is the Langlands dual group of G. So G is defined using Cudator. In the list of examples here, so I keep the same order. So G check for G, GLN, it is the same type of group but over a complex number. But as you see here, if you start with a group present which is of which is semi-simple, it's actually the two which is, so if you start with a group which is simply connected, then the G check is of Adam type and vice versa. So in the case of SLN, its Langlands dual is of Adam type, so it is GLN over C, and for classical groups, for SP2N, normal group is SO2N plus 1. And okay, N is odd. Is here, it depends on the parity of N. So you see, if N is 2N plus 1, of course, you will get here a symplectic group. N over C, and if N is even, we just get similar. And for exceptional groups, will be much more exceptional here, but exceptional group from G, and just say that E and G shape are of same type. Smooth irreducible representation
of G. So these are the objects we are interested in. So in the notation of the previous talk, when if G is GLM, introduce this notation, which is the same as G. So I will try always to use this notation A and F when I have to, when I have to talk about G for G equal to GLM. And so local long-longs correspondence is a define a map from this set to this set, which is not I didn't have yet defined, which suggests good properties, and I will say more soon. So what is the object here? So here it will be a set of G-check on GBC classes of long-longs parameter. It should be defined later. So long-longs parameter. Say for the moment that they are homomorphism from the direct product of the Weyl group. The Weyl group, sorry, English, in fact, say Weyl. The Weyl group of F cross SL2C. This corresponds to the Weyl-Baldolin group of F, absolute of F. Here the W, I will call the definition, but it is, as before, the absolute Weyl group. So F is a separable, F bar is a separable closure of F, and the long-longs parameter, so it's a map, an homomorphism, is a later, an admissible homomorphism and its image is contained in G-check. So just be careful here, it is going to into a G-check because I assume for a moment that the group G is just to simplify the exposition. So, in the particular case when G is GLM, G check is just, as I am just rewriting it, GLM over C. So if G is element, then the map as before, but here long-longs parameter is an homomorphism from the Baldolin group to GLM over C, and the restriction of phi to WF is homomorphism from the Baldolin to GLM over C. So of course you can view it as a recommendation of the WF of dimension N. And if of G, if you restrict to the most interesting case, which is given by the connection here of G, by the set of subset of pi, which are pi is possible. So when G is GLN F, I'm still taking G is equal to GLN F, then in that case, notation. And so the Langlands, the local Langlands is one map causing the first block here to here. So here you have representation. Because you take this little representation, it will also always, you will always attach an irreducible representation here, an homomorphism phi, a Langlands parameter, which is trivial on the SL2C. So it just it is equal to this restriction. So it's just a representation of WF2C of n of the dimension n, and it has to, and the result is that it has to be irreducible. So it's just a map. Here, where here is, if I reduce it to set of equivalence classes of irreducible, of n-dimensional irreducible representations of the divide. So this is just to figure out your link, what you have already said. So, result is due to Paris Saint-Germain, Michael Alexander Schachterer. Soon after, you have to get an independent proof by the ENA. And later, another proof by Peter Schosser. So this is for the case, which is, I say, is the most interesting case of hospital civil representation. But in fact, in this case, it's more general, so it's a bijection between E of G and phi of G. We satisfy the expected order. And again, it's unique. It's unique by region, satisfying that word. So I will explain more precisely the position of uniqueness in the next talk. So, it's of course already in Kuznel talk, this bijection is existing, it's unique, so it's the right one because we have because it satisfies it's the unique one which satisfies the list of importing one. Nevertheless, it doesn't say that it is explicit at all. And GLN, so it's already very extremely difficult stuff and interesting. But the story is not finished because if you look at the smallest example, which is not GLN, like SL2, sorry,
the fabric of pi, the representation pi, that's why n of pi is equal. So what is expected and what is proved to be the case in numerous cases is that pi fig are always finite set. So in the case of GLN, the fact that it is a bijectory means that this set are singletons. So in general, they are not singletons, but they're likely to be finite set. And that P of G, I'm just rewriting the fact that this is expected to be a bijection. And they are expected to be finite set and disjoint. So it means if phi is not in the same, which phi 1, phi 2, which are not conjugate by the dual group, then this set does not have any intersection. So and the pi phi are called n packets or long ones. So the point is, in some sense, we can divide the problem in two steps, attach first to irreducible representation pi and long one parameter phi, and then we get a finite set of irreducible representation, and the problem is how to compute it, to parameterize it by data which can come from the dual side. So I am just erasing so usually I would call this periodic group side, and this will be called the dual side or gamma subdual or gamma side of the correspondence. So so we would like to have a bijection between E of G and some set, which is made using data attached to the bi group. So for that, we introduce the following set. A Langmuir parameter when G is not GLN in general is not enough. So we will have to enhance it by some other object. So we will call this new set as VE, G, E is for enhance. And so what is this set? It will be a set of pair. Still have our Langmuir parameter, so phi is in Langmuir parameter or a parameter. And what is rho? Rho is an irreducible representation of a small finite group. So what is this group? It's a finite group, and it is defined as follows. So you consider the central actor of the notation. So define G check phi as the centralizer in G
jib shape of the image of phi, which means phi of the volume phi of A. I'm just recalling the notation. So phi is going from variable input to jib shape. So I take the image by phi of the volume prime F. And so I get a subgroup of G-check, considering G-check the centralizer of this subgroup, and call it like this. This group is still a complex energy group. But in general, it's not connected. And you know what call G check by zero, it's identity component, the identity component of G check by identity component. And here you will just take the quotient of the group of essentially the group of components of that group G-shake, essentially because you want to divide also by the center, which is essentially the center of the G-shake. So this is our group we are looking for. The reason why we need to divide by the center will be later when I will consider not only one group but all its inner form. So just define it like this and then define this set, and now what is expected when it is known is the following. Is that this set is a right set to parameterize the set of the classes of the principal superposition of G. Representation of that small group. was the first person who had the idea of introducing this book. To be honest, I don't know precisely. Who was this idea? So I'm tempted to do it. Many people are working on this, many others. So I will say, maybe this is not completely correct, but you are happy to correct it. So for periodic groups, I will say, I would like to attribute this to George Lustig in a paper in 1983, which is called the Square Integral Representation, in which we which appear this group exactly in that setting. I guess this idea was already in the air and was already used for real group by Langlands and himself and also Chester. You will see already it in Corvallis, for instance in Chester paper in Corvallis. Of course, Vaughan, Arthur, and maybe again Lustig. I mean, for sure Lustig did this, but it's not for periodic. In the case of finite groups. So this is in the 70s. So in the 70s, so okay, I guess this idea was and maybe also the link, because probably the link, because when in I think it is in 1987, Kajan and Lustig study proved a special case, a very important case, at the same time another special case. The proof of the Lingon, we call it proof of the Lingon-Gauss conjecture, and I think in that paper they attribute this enhancement to an idea of the Lingon-Gauss conjecture. So, and the case we studied here was for the representation P such that P admits involving its vector. And this this is related to in particular to aspect. First, it is related to the it's a special for GRN, it is a special case of a I mean it's a representation which are close to the one we see in the previous talk at the end, which are not clustered, but who are coming from the representation of our finite group, which is not clustered. And the study by the proof by Kajan and Lustig of this conjecture it was using the main tool was to use a fine equilateral. So a fine equilateral will show them, which will show up in many talks in the workshop and also in the conference, and especially in Eric Obdam and Alan Roche talk. So this is a general process that to study representations which are not superclustered, and also the source, the finite. So this is just to say, it's just a major to this conference, and then so this is not to be true in many cases, in particular in the following cases. him in the following verses. Of course, he called GLI, it's a special case of a previous statement, and it's in our form. For G is equal to SLI. This is due to, so here I didn't call it Alessandro any other short term economy. SLN, this is due to impact Alessandro. When the characteristic of the film is equal to zero, so this gives me the opportunity to say that this means that this occurs when F is a finite extension of QP, right, of the field of periodic integers, right, extension of QP. We have X limit. We extend it to the case of positive. When the characteristic of F is not zero, which is equal to P, and this is when F is finite extension of the field of formal studies of F. And the method here is just one pass to characteristic F equal to zero to characteristic positive characteristic by using the delinquent method of both. Meaning that the proof when in the case where the film has a positive characteristic is used as a crucial ingredient, the result in the case of the zero characteristic. And this is a general process. Yes?
This is not clear. Will you pass to characteristic zero from characteristic P?
Yes. I mean, it means that the result was already known in the case of characteristic zero. And then you prove it. It's going to extend it to the field of characteristic P. So you start with the field which has characteristic P, and it's possible to find the field with zero characteristic, which is sufficiently close in a precise way from our field of characteristic
P. And usual perfectoid stasis things,
they are doing exactly
the
other
direction.
Process. Yes. Yes, perfectly. Yes, it's. It's very good that you say this, because I forgot. So, I forgot something. When in GLN, I quote Alice Taylor and Louis Rothbard, but this was for characteristic film of characteristic zero. And it was for any film, in fact, I proved it. No, it was for characteristic zero, but for GLN, one. Characteristic of F is equal to P, it's positive. The reason was known many years ago, and it was due to Lomon-Rapoport-Hachetoul. years that when you have a firm which has positive characteristics, you can use geometric tools. And so in some sense, it's not easier, but it's, we have at your, in your hand, if you know the tools, so geometric tools, and you can do, apply this, this kind of thing with success. Okay, and when we feel that can be zero characteristic, we cannot. And now there is this new theory of perfectly spaces, which is introduced by Peter Schulze, and hopefully it will give a way to pass in some sense to construct geometric objects in this, inspired by what people have done before in characteristics. Here is just the opposite. So it's sometimes characteristics zero case is easier because it's, we can use some more analysis method which will not apply in positive characteristics. So in characteristics zero, we have, it's easier to use analysis, it's more difficult to use geometry. And then sometimes we can use this diagnostic agent method to pass from stage to another. So I have still. So, see, it's an end. Now, classical groups. So, SO is P on the form. Again. So, it's known to be proved by the work of Jim Arthur. So it's essentially his book, 500 pages, and the book itself was conditional to the something that was used in first fundamental lemma, and also some result about crystallization of a twisted trace formula, which are now proved by Neuvlin and especially by Stoget. So for classical groups, that when by Vincent Laforgue, this is global, and there is also a work in progress of Lacan and Genestier. To adapt, the method of Lafort for global case to this case of positive characteristic. Again, share virtually, but now characteristic zero. So it's also working in progress.
Point, the point we mean with is that S here is given by
Ouais. L is Levy subgroup of G, and sigma is an irreducible representation of L, which is a small. So of course, in this set, we have a case where L is equal to G. In that case, you just have, in particular, when S is, when L is G, then in that case, if GS is just that you with tensor, so pi is here is an irreducible representation of G, and you will tensor pi, so assume that it is fixed, and you will tensor it by some character with A of all the unamplified character. Unamplified character. Character of L. So in general, it's, this is the case of when the Levy is G, which was going to be the case of the spatial representation, and here the case is defined using parabolic or rational induction from the spatial representation of the Levy subgroup of G, as you have already seen in the case of GLN, the parabolic subgroup, the Levy subgroup of it. So this is the case of at the level of representation. So what Clary Chambard tell to us is that when you have a smooth irreducible representation, you can view them as attached to them a Levy and a super, and the first order representation of that Levy, and fix that Levy and that first order representation up to some twist of a character, and just look at this series. And what it is expected again. So this will not be, I will not talk about this more. It's just to fix ideas. So what is expected is that here, G, S, and digestion, this is in digestion with the simple modules. Extended or generalized defined equation. So this is a generalization of the situation that I should just evocated before regarding the work of Perjan and Lossig. Okay, this is known in many cases, essentially the cases that I used before, so GLN, so this is known for GLN. GLN is SLN is Bouchner-Gasco for the case of Gasco dans representation. There is Goldberg and Alain Roche for all the other cases. For inner form of GLN, Vincent Seychelles, so first from Boussous and also Singh, for Bistar also. Vincent Seychelles, and classical groups. So, maximum parabolic. And classical close, no condition of the parabolic, but the local characteristic of the higher hand. So in many cases, this is known. Okay. So what we want to do? Try to adapt this algebra philosophy on the dual side. Which means do this. But yes, partition this set of an asymptotic parameter by similar kind of things. But yes, it's not the option. Out of this, and I will stop here, P, E, G, S, check. Where S check is here given by a normal dual of the Levy subgroup of G, and I guess you can imagine what it should be here. So here it is some sigma is in here L plus. So here it is an object like here, but connected to, I would call it phi epsilon, bar phi epsilon. And what is this? This is an object in phi E L, which has to be just below in a certain sense, which we'll explain tomorrow. So it will go to have a Bajitron, and of course, what expected result is what? Not any decomposition, but random, but just that fact. In fact, here, H, E, S will be in Bajitron with this Alexander series at the level of n as long as y. And of course here we have S and that check, of course it is when S corresponds to S check. And look at what it means. So here you have a Levy, you have a longitudinal Levy, and just means that if S is L phi, and you want that phi, and this is given here, you want that phi corresponds to phi epsilon, so phi is a cuspidal representation here, it's not a cuspidal representation of n, and you want that it corresponds to this object here by the number of correspondence. So I will stop here, and then next one I will define this, in particular, I will explain this.
Questions?
Yes. In the middle, which you raised, and on the right, you listed a bunch of instances where the local Langmuir correspondence was proved, and you said local Langmuir correspondence should satisfy a list of properties.
Yes.
The things that you, the names that you listed and the situations that you listed, did people prove that all the properties are satisfied there, or what did they actually show?
Okay, first, I will explain later, but the property is not enough. I mean, you have to in fact, we do not have any one non-North correspondent, but we first need to fix the Whittaker datum first. And for, then when this is, and I will explain this next time, so when we have fixed the Whittaker datum, then it is expected to have a unique correspondence. Has been, of course, for Cherenkov it has been proved. For the other group, we have interesting results in that direction, especially in the work by Ganapati and Varma, which we proved that. After I proved that is map, is bijection satisfies certain property, and Sandeep should correct me if I am correct. So what they prove is that the so vexon first correspond only defined by Archer to the case of positive characteristic, and they also prove that it satisfies the correspondence between the L function for pairs up to some condition, which will, this condition involves the notion of depth, which will be explained later. And but I do not think that there is a really uniqueness in that proof, except in the case of GSP4. And its inner form, which is due to the Vitaigan and Tashu-Takeda, in that case, we prove that it is unique. And so if there is a unique map, because the list of properties includes the correspondence of L function for pairs, and also correspondence for in terms of partial form. I do not know if this is enough. Answer
what the question.
Yes.
What about the situation for SLM? I mean, this Gilbert and Knapp already had, you take GLN, you restrict, you get a bunch of representations, and that presumably is in bijection with this extra row.
Yes, exactly. Yes.
And
yes, so for the package for SLN is given, so you when you start with a representation of SLN, you can always it always occurs in the restriction of the geological representation of GLN to SLN, and that restriction, when you restrict the restriction, it does not stay geological in general, and so you get a finite bunch of geological representation, which will be the L package for SLN.
And there's no further noises to be made about uniqueness of the bijection with respect to NS parameters. It's all automatic, is it?
No, it's not automatic. Based on that problem that we declared it. Which was mentioned by Gross and Grider in paper known as correspondence. Even when you're running SL2, we have a packet with four cuspidal geological representation in it, and all of them admit a Whittaker model. And so, if we fix one Whittaker model, it's fine. Okay? For this specific Whittaker model, we can prove that it's unique.
You need a base point in that packet.
Yeah, base point in the air packet. But if you do not fix the base point in the air packet, yeah. I do not know. I think it's
not possible. I don't know. Are there other questions?
Yes?
Phi epsilon is related.
Sorry?
So the phi epsilon, they're related.
What do you say about the phi epsilon?
Is it related to
a finite
algebra?
Is it related to a finite algebra?
Yeah, are you relating it to the affine Hecke algebra?
Yes, it is related, but not in the main way. In this side, which is probably well known to you, when you start with S, we define the equation we would attach to S with something like that. In fact, we find a projective progenerator attached to this full subcategory of the category of small representation of G, and we consider the commutation of on the morphism. Commutative algebra of this progenerator, this will give you the Hecke algebra. So it's similar here, it's essentially similar here. So this will play the role of the Hecke algebra will be something like that. So you will have one affine Hecke algebra for each phi epsilon.
More questions? Send this to the